Well, it's a beautiful day on Shuswap Lake. Welcome back to ShuswapMarina.com. On the lot today, we have a very special boat. This is a 2017 Super Air Nautique G23. The creme de la creme of surf boats. This boat is very lightly used with only 120 hours on it since new. It has been professionally maintained its entire life. And we will take a little walk around and go over some of the very cool features that you will find on this boat. Now, first of all, the Nautique hull on the Super Air Nautique G23 makes what many call the very best surf wave there is behind a boat. It is ultra customizable for your wake shape and size to everybody's abilities that are on your boat. You can save user profiles for different levels of ballast and all that kind of thing. So it's as simple as selecting your profile and then the boat sets itself up the way you have programmed it to, and off you go. And when the next rider wants to go, just select them and the boat does its thing. This boat has just come out of our detail shop. It is summerized and ready to go on this beautiful triple axle trailer. It's actually got a very nice color scheme, not gaudy in any way. We will hop inside and show you some more of the features in there. All right, and here we have the 2017 Super Air Nautique G23 view from the swim platform. So we've got a nice big swim platform back here, all covered in sea deck. There is even a pull-out boarding ladder in the middle of the swim grid here. Very rare to see on a surf boat. I love the quality touches, like these huge oversized stern eyes. This nice grab rail here that also is your tow point for skis and tubes. We've also got a really nice sea deck step here that hides a nice cooler that is draining as well, self-draining. Can also be used for your ropes and that kind of thing. It's also a great place to sit while you put your board on before your ride. Very well thought out. And I love this walkthrough. Big and luxurious, as they say. I love being able to get in and out of a boat without having to step on upholstery. And Nautique does a great job of making that happen. You've got a molded in step on each side of the boat as well. So you can actually step right over the upholstery even if you're coming on from the dock. Very cool. And as we walk through here, you can see there's also a step in the center of this cushion. Once again, don't have to step on any upholstery. And as a result, we're in a 6-year-old boat here and this upholstery is immaculate. Now, before we hop into the boat, I will definitely mention this has the upgraded stereo system. So these are 4 8.8-inch JL Audio tower speakers. It's an upgrade from the stock 7.7s. This also has the upgraded over-the-tower bimini top that has a pocket on each side for a surfboard. Really handy to have that storage up here for some water toys. We all know how quickly storage fills up in a boat. Speaking of which, when we open both of these compartments here, you'll see that all of these, anything that opens on this boat has a gas strut on it or is properly hinged so that it will not fall on you while you're trying to get in there and get your stuff. All the compartments are lined with a sea deck material, which A, makes it look luxurious, but also stops anything from rattling that's in the bottom of your boat. Also, this compartment goes right forward. So you can fit full-size wakeboards, surfboards, all that kind of stuff in here with no problem. Another cool feature we have are these hooks for you to hang ropes or life jackets on so they can hang dry. These compartments all drain into your bilge. They don't keep water trapped here. Here is the storage for the filler cushions for the walkthrough here. Once again, really well thought out. We're hanging them there. They're not going to get manky and moldy. Very nicely thought out, well executed. The other thing that makes all this storage so good is the fact all of your ballast, 2,850 pounds worth, is all subfloor hard tanked ballast. There are no bags in this boat cluttering up your compartments, getting moldy and manky. Once again, great storage in here. Great space to stow your table and the leg for the table. And that all just installs right here on the port side of the cockpit. You can see the mount on the side there just below the cushion. Yet another cool option that these owners decided to go for were the fender locks. So around the boat, you've got intelligent spots to mount a fender very easily and quickly. Very cool, very clean when they're not in use. Nothing there to trip on or stub your toe on. Very, very well thought out. And as we step further into the boat, so at each kind of station, each space there is to sit, you've got ample cup holders. These all have LED light rings on them. Got a JL audio speaker. You've also got a 12 volt plug plus two USB plugs. These nice grab handles. So many quality touches everywhere you look on this boat. Once again, on the combing sides, we're all covered in sea deck. There'll be no slipping getting on or off the boat at any point around here, which is a really cool feature. Not only is it a luxurious touch, it's a safety thing. So, as I said before, all your cushions are well hinged. They stay up, they don't fall on you. Lovely compartments lined with sea deck. We've actually got a battery maintenance system on here, so a battery charger that you can plug in. Keep your batteries topped up nicely. Access for your batteries is nice and easy. Right here in the center hatch, access to both your batteries, all your ballast pumps, one of your bilge pumps, all your through hulls. Very clever the way they have laid this boat out. So often we see boat manufacturers and engineers that make things purely for form and not function. The Nautique ethos seems to be, we want form and function. Another example of that is this fold-away surf viewing seat, or I guess rear action viewing seat. So you kind of get a bit of a theater setup here. So we have this seat that is now rear facing, so you can watch the action. This is a stowable flip seat here. And then on the port side, we've actually got another flip-up seat there. You'll see in the pictures that I have on this ad as well how this looks from the backside as you're looking forward into the boat. Once again, everything looks quality and feels quality. There's a little compartment here where you can stash some stuff or use it as a trash can. Very, very well thought out. This bimini top, it's worth noting, is huge and really well covers the whole cockpit area. It's very cool. Got a really big, beefy rear view mirror, as well as what they call the awareness cam. So this boat comes standard with a rear facing camera. Let's see if I can activate it. Yeah, so there you go. You can see everything behind us. And it's a very wide angle camera. It's very cool. The tower also has a mount for a GoPro, So you can set your GoPro up there and catch all your sessions. This boat was also optioned with a fancy upgraded steering wheel. It's also tilt steering here. While we're here at the helm, I'll show you more of the functions here. So your screen is also a touch screen, and you have this joystick controller here to help navigating it and making it even easier. Even your shifter knob, leather wrapped, just feels so nice in the hand. This boat has huge capacity, 16 people. And you've got these really cool little pockets near the helm for your keys and wallet and all that kind of stuff. Stuff's not going to go flying around. Got this cool pocket here for your smartphone. And another bit of real estate here where you can leave keys or whatever else. It's not going to fly around on you. Got USB charging here. We do have a heater outlet on here that'll act as a defroster on those cooler days in spring and fall when you're out riding. Also got a vented windshield on both sides. Very cool touch. Another part of the stereo upgrade that this boat came with is what's called the wavefront speakers by JL Audio. Now these are a special enclosure with a speaker mounted down below the dash that pipes full range music up against the windshield and fills the whole cockpit with sound, just on a different level than anything else. Keeps everything really clear and easy to hear, even when you're bombing down the lake trying to outrun a storm. As I said before, this boat does have the upgraded stereo system, so that has three JL Audio amplifiers. We've got the six cockpit speakers, the two wavefront speakers, plus under the heated love seat here, we have a 12-inch JL Audio sub. Once again, this is an enormous storage compartment here. You could sleep in here. I mean, no joke. Very cool. Every little thing that you touch in this boat feels quality. Even the glove box has a gas strut on it, has these C-deck pieces inside it. Your stuff's not going to rattle around and be annoying that way. You got this cool little slidable tray that goes from side to side and actually locks in. So this is the Polk Audio head unit, but everything is controllable through the Nautique interface over on the helm. You do have a nice big mirror here too. Very cool feature. Another thing that's under that love seat that I'll show you access is here is a garbage can, right? Very cool to have access to that through the walk-thru. And then over here we've got your power center with your battery switch and breakers. Once again, we don't have to get into an engine compartment or under a bunch of seats to get to that. Very well thought out. Yet another option as we come forwards is this air dam door. Works really well, just a nice solid piece. It's not a piece of Lexan that's sculling around the boat getting all scratched up all the time. You know, when you're not using this, it just slides away and the latch just clicks away. Everything just has positive engagement and feels good. All right, up in our bow seating, the theme continues. Tons of cup holders. Tons of power. We've got 12 volt and dual USB plugs everywhere. These seats also lift up, are also C-decked underneath. And we still don't see any evidence of the ballast. It is all so nicely hidden. We've got a great filler cushion in here on the bow. Also, upgraded armrests for both your bow seating guests. It's just so cool. We actually have three pop-up cleats down each side. Plus a nice pop-up fitting for your mooring whips up on the front here. A very, very nice boat. There's definitely nothing made like a Super Air Nautique. There are other high-end wake surf boats, but hands down, these are the best made and fitted out that I have seen. We'll pop open that engine hatch and have a look in there. It is a PCM H6, 6.2 liter direct injection, naturally aspirated V8, making 450 horse and 465 pound-feet of torque. Not leaving you wanting for power, that is for sure. This boat, as I said before, is 120 hours since new, has been professionally maintained, always had the oil changed, summerized, winterized every year. Got your automatic fire extinguisher back here as well. And all of these hatches and everything drain water away from the motor. It's all guttered and piped so that all the water goes straight down into the bilge. Hey everybody, we're the Foo Fighters. Very well thought out. And I'm Justin from the Bluestone. So there you have it. It's a 2017 Super Air Nautique G23, 120 hours, since new, in immaculate condition, on the triple axle trailer, ready to hit the water and make all your friends jealous, to the point where they just want to come and ride with you. And how much fun is that? That is what it's all about. Getting all your friends and family out on the water for unforgettable days of epic wakes. Thanks for coming by ShoeSwapMarina.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the water.